Hey guys, it's John with Ideaform 3D, and today I'm going to show you how you can use Google Earth and Reality Capture to capture a 3D model of a place that you really like and 3D print it. So if you visit google.com/earth, you can download Google Earth for free. Right at the top I'm going to hit Earth Versions. And the one we want for this project is at the very bottom. It's Download Earth Pro on Desktop. So once you have Google Earth installed, we'll launch it. And the first step, if we click on View, we want to hide the toolbar and the sidebar. We want to hide as many user interface elements as possible, so we're left with a nice image for the photogrammetry software. So the next step, I'll go to Tools, Options, and I want to, under Texture Colors, I want to turn off Compress. I want to turn my anisotropic filtering to High, and I want to change my anti-aliasing to High. And then I'm going to hit Apply. This is going to make sure that I get the cleanest, highest res textures and image, which our photogrammetry software will deal with a lot better when creating the 3D model. Okay, so I'm going to restart the application to make sure those settings took effect. And let's find a spot that we want to create a 3D model of. So let's zoom into my hometown, Reno. So here's Lake Tahoe in California and Nevada. And just north of Lake Tahoe is Reno. So I'm going to zoom in to an area that I like to hike at. We'll just zoom in to a cool little hill over here. So this is a pretty cool little spot. There's a cool hill that we can fly around and survey for our photogrammetry software. So now you want to be screen capturing your navigation inside of Google Earth. And so a great program for this is OBS, Open Broadcaster Software. It's free and it allows you to capture what you see on your screen. So we'll load up OBS, and right now I'm just capturing my screen. I'm going to hide my logo and my toolbar. And the important thing in your screen capture software is you want to go to the video settings. So if I hit settings, I want to just make sure that my output is as high resolution as it can go. So right now it's at 1080p, that should be good. And the next thing, I want to make sure that my video bit rate is fairly high, like a minimum of 40,000 kbps, which is 40 megabits per second. So this looks good. We're ready to go with our capture software. Okay, so I just started capturing our screen and we're ready to start capturing our images. So I want to capture this mountain right here. I want to be a good distance away so I can fly around in circles. Almost the way I think of it is almost like a helicopter surveying an area. So the first pass, I'm going to be a little more low angle, maybe zoom in one more click. And I want to move this hand to the very bottom of the screen and just middle mouse click and drag and then pan. And the same thing over and over. I just want to, in a circular motion, fly around this hill almost as if I'm a helicopter surveying it in a circle. So it's a little tricky trying to get trying to fly around it in a circle, but after you do a couple clicks, you get kind of used to it. So after I've made almost a full loop around this mountain, the next step, I don't want to zoom at all because that can mess with the photogrammetry. I just want to middle mouse click and come down on it from a higher angle and then do the same thing from this higher angle. I want to fly around it, kind of like a helicopter in a loop. So we're just kind of surveying the land. And we're almost done here. And I want to just keep my clicking at the very bottom so that doesn't confuse the photogrammetry software. And there we go. We've done our two loops. Now I'm just going to go back to my capture software and I'm going to stop it. All right, so we just finished capturing us flying around and surveying this hill in Google Earth, almost like we're a helicopter. The next step is using a video editor. I find After Effects to be the most useful because we can import the footage and we can control the frame rate, which will be an important part of this process. So now that I have my clip imported into After Effects, I'm going to find my in and out points. So I just want to find the start of where we started surveying the hill. So it looks like it happened about right there. I'm going to hit Control Shift D, which will split the clip, and I'm going to get rid of the beginning and just slide this over at the very beginning. So now I want to find the end and just trim the end off. So same thing, I'm going to find the spot where we finished flying around our hill. And it looks like it happened about right there. So I'm going to trim that, and that will be our out point. And now here's the important tricky part. We have this region of us flying around and surveying this hill. Oh, one more step. I'm going to zoom out and I'm just going to scale this video clip up until I get rid of the Google Earth logo and the toolbars. So now we're kind of just left with what almost looks like a video of us flying around this hill. We still kind of see the cursor, but I've found that the photogrammetry software doesn't get too hung up on it. Another thing, if we zoom in, it looks a little blurry, so I'm going to right click and I'm going to apply a sharpen, and I'm just going to crank this up until it looks like it's getting a little sharpness. So that looks good, about 25. And the last step, which is the most important part, I'm going to right click on my composition and hit composition settings. Right now, my frame rate is 30 frames per second. So that is about 2,000 frames that we have of us flying around. So the trick here is I'm going to go back into composition settings and I'm going to make my frame rate 2. And what that does is it drops the frame count from around 2,000 to a much more reasonable number, about 150. So that'll be perfect. And then I'm going to hit Control M to render those 150 frames. I'm going to change this to a JPEG sequence, and I'm going to save this in a folder called 3D scan on my desktop. Hit save, and I'm going to hit render. And since we changed the frame rate to 2 frames per second, 2 FPS, now it's rendering 150 frames from the recording that we did, and this is the data that we're going to put into Reality Capture to create our 3D model. All right, guys, so here's my folder with all of our images that we rendered, all 150 frames of us flying around in Google Earth. So it's pretty cool. You can step through it, and it kind of just looks like a helicopter flying around. So next step, I'm going to start up the photogrammetry software I'm using, and this software is called Reality Capture, and this is the software that can convert a bunch of images into a 3D model. So this is really cool software. So I'm going to jump back to our folder with all our images. I'm going to hit Control A to select them all, and I'm just going to drag them into this project. And the next step, I'm going to hit the Alignment tab, and I'm just going to hit Align Images. Okay, guys, Reality Capture just finished aligning all of our images from After Effects. And as you can see here, it did something really cool. It found out where all of those camera positions are in 3D space, and it created what's called a point cloud, which is kind of like a really rough representation of our 3D scene. So the next thing, I'm going to zoom out, and using these colorful handles, I'm going to crop in on just the section that I want to create a 3D model. All right, once I'm happy with my crop, I'm going to go into reconstruction, and I'm going to hit normal detail. And what this is going to do now is this is going to take all of our cameras and the point cloud information and convert it into an actual 3D model that we can 3D print. All right, guys, so Reality Capture just finished creating the high detail 3D model, and it looks beautiful. Reality Capture did a great job at just capturing really subtle details in the rock formations, and I'm just really happy with the result. It looks so good. I can't wait to 3D print this. So I'm going to get it into Mesh Mixer and clean it up really quick and then send it to my 3D printer. All right, guys, so I did a little more cleanup, cleaned up some of the trees, and finished it by doing Edit Make Solid, which takes your mesh and just turns it into a nice, clean, watertight mesh for your 3D printer. So I'm really happy with how this turned out, and let's go ahead and send it to the 3D printer. All right, guys, here's the 3D print, and it turned out really good. I printed this on an Anycubic Photon at a layer height of 0.05 millimeters, and it did a great job of capturing all the fine details from the 3D model we created. So overall, this has been a really fun project. It's really cool to have a 3D print of an area that's unique to me and a place that I've experienced. So I think this has been a lot of fun, and it's a very unique way of being able to use Google Earth and Reality Capture to create a 3D model of an area that you know. So if you guys liked this video and you enjoyed this tutorial, leave a like and subscribe to my channel. And I'll leave links to all the software in the comments below. Thanks again for watching, and have a good day, guys. Bye.